Diane, if you want to move up here, then you're welcome to, or stay where you are. Why don't you move up to the left?
Take your name tags.
All right, thank you, and now, 3 minute opening statement, we'll start with the incumbent, Terry McGregor. When you're ready.
Okay. Good evening, everyone, and thank you for the opportunity to reintroduce myself to you. I'm Terry McGregor, and I'm your current treasurer tax collector. I have served in this office for over 10 years now. To give you a personal perspective on me, I was born in a little town on the East Coast, and my husband was born in a little town on the West Coast. We met in the middle in a big city called Dallas. After visiting his hometown of Weaverville, it won my heart, and we decided that this is a place where we wanted to raise our children. My husband and I have 2 adult children, and we have 1 teenage son. We are also current foster parents as well. We are grateful to have this close-knit community for all of our children. I've held this position since 2009. My finance and banking experience spans 20 plus years. I hold a bachelor's degree in accounting with an emphasis in business administration. I'm a credentialed California County senior executive through CSAC. The credential that I hold through CSAC is a 2-year program that has specific curriculum requirements designated for county officials, and it's built on a foundation of leadership and policy competencies that's expected of effective county officials. As treasurer, I'm also in charge of our capital reserves, which means balancing the needs of various constituents within the guidelines of our policies as well as the state codes. Safety, liquidity, and return within the cash flow restraints of our county and other depositors are my mandate. Additionally, I serve as a depository performing cash management functions for all funds belonging to the county, schools, and special districts within the county. As tax collector, I administer the billing, the collection, and reporting functions of property tax revenues levied for the county, schools, and special districts. I ensure proper internal controls to perform accounting and fiscal record keeping duties and the collection of taxes. We continue to serve as a check and balance system for the other departments. I'd like to highlight a few accomplishments. I initiated features to accept credit cards throughout the county departments. I maintained a respectable rate of return on our investments. I've implemented new programs and procedures that have returned delinquencies into revenue generating status. I've lobbied to reinstate the property tax postponement program for seniors and disabled citizens. Trinity County is dear to my heart with its beautiful mountains, fresh air, and quality of living opportunities. I care deeply about our community and those that live here, and I'm committed to making this county great. I believe the combination of my experience and education makes me the best person to represent our community as treasurer tax collector. Thank you, Sir Optimus, Judge Letton, for hosting the event and moderating, and thank you to everyone for coming out tonight. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Diane Richards. I'm very honored to be here in front of you and be able to converse with you one-on-one. As we left our home and traveled through Hay Fork Valley, a bald eagle flew over our car, which is a wonderful omen. And that's what I want to protect is our freedom. And I've found many problems here in our county. And I want to address those, and I have been. I've been doing a citizens independent audit. I was stymied by the county council. But many of the things that I found and that people helped me find, including the auditor's office, was that we have a lot of red flags here. One of the things that people should be aware is that there is a independent audit of our accounts, of our monies here in the county every year. However, it's the same auditor year after year after year. They give each other awards. The county awards them for being a wonderful independent auditor, and they give the county an award for being a wonderful county. Yet, the red flags are there. We have negative cash balances. For instance, one of the accounts is the grants program, $500,000 negative. Where did that money go? It's never been determined. It sits there year after year undetermined, including the problems still are there from the hospital, still sits on our books. I've had many people come up to me and say that they went and paid their tax bill when the office was open because they had very limited hours until recently when I filed my statement that I would be keep the office open 9 to 5, that they were then billed for the same bill that they just paid. And I said, well, did you get a receipt? Did you get anything? And so there are red flags for that. There is also from very good sources that we have someone working there who was accused of embezzlement 3 times in 3 different finance institutions. I think that there should be different hiring practices in that office where we're dealing with $100 million in state and federal mandate funds plus our county funds every year. So we need to have perhaps a polygraph for anyone that works there. We need to have a tight ship run. I do have experience in finance and in business. I've run many, many businesses. And I do want to mention my family. My greatest achievement, I believe, is a mother of 6, including a miraculous birth of triplets, 2 of which are Hayford Fire fighters as well as EMTs. All my children are contributing members of society, and that's what I'm doing here while I'm running today. Thank you very much.
Okay, I'm synthesizing several questions here. If you would, identify some specific duties of the Treasurer Tax Collector's Office, and then explain what specific formal education or on-the-job experience or training that you have that apply to those duties. Terry?
Well, as I've stated, I do have a degree. I've also continued my education as far as through different governmental agencies that CSAC, CDAC. In addition to part of being elected, there are educational requirements that you must continue your education every year. So I have that education. In addition to my own enrichment, specific duties that we have in the office, I manage over a $45 million pool on average. We have daily duties. I have personnel management. We have several duties on the tax collection side specifically, and all of these are done within their strict regulations from code and laws, rules, and regulations that we have to follow. So there's quite a few different education that we have on that.
Okay. I have a lot of experience, particularly on the corporate side in finance, and I was a protege of World Security Fund, which was insurance at a very high level for expropriation and confiscation, protection for American corporations across around the world. And there are other things that I do have experience in. One of the things I can do is actually read law and read books. When I went in for the audit, I asked for the CAFR, which is a comprehensive annual financial report. It was very difficult to get. Finally, the prior auditor did help me get that, and I found that we had surrendered our courthouse and our detention center for an 8.5% loan, interest loan, that continues to this day, which was illegal for us to obtain and throw into the general fund. So that could be sold at a lower rate, which is available right now. Some of our investments that we have, mutual funds, have been running since 1992 without change. Thank you.
Is public input important for this office? And if so, how should it be utilized, or how would you promote public input? Terry?
I have public input all the time. I have people, being that we're a small community, some folks call me on my cell phone and like to give me their public input, but I have a tax collector email, I have a treasurer email, along with a personal county email and a personal email. So I have lots of individuals that give me their input. People come to the counter. I have an open door policy, so I do take those into consideration. Depending on what code allows for, I try to take that into consideration. If it's something that's allowable, that can accommodate what the public would like, I do try to accommodate it if at all possible.
All right, I get a lot of input. I'm actually the editor of the Trinity Gazette, so I get a lot of calls and tips and what have you. But one of the things that's very vital here that is not being done, not only do we not have transparency, every single account that we have should be on the website so we know what the totals are every month. But what we don't have that a treasurer's department should have is an oversight committee, and that would be made up of members of the public, ex-accountants, ex-CPAs. We need that 10 to 12 people to look at what's going there, not on them there, not just internal. There are internal problems there. It's in the audit. It said that they have internal issues. And I'm not privy, don't have privy to the letters that they say exactly what that is, but there's something there as well as the negative balances.
Thanks. Investment experience. What experience or ideas do you have specific to the type of county investments that need to be managed by with the influence of your office? Carrie?
As I said before, I do have the formal educational experience in addition to the education specific to managing a governmental public funds portfolio. So I basically, there is a methodical cash flow process, and as far as making sure that all of my pool participants, I'm looking at what their needs are to make sure that what I'm investing coincides with what the needs are for the different pool participants, making sure that times up with the cash flows of what we have for our dry periods, making sure that those are within the limitations and restrictions that we have for our investment policy as far as government code allows. So those are, and basically that's the some restrictions that we, some of the investing we do.
Okay, Diane?
The state does mandate how you invest certain percentages that you can do. When I was looking at some of our investments, one that pops up that I don't like is our investment of $2 million since 1992 in a French company that was fined for excessive fees. So I'm not really sure if we're making any money there. It says that anywhere from 1 to 1% return there. However, what are the fees? It doesn't address that. And this company was notorious. I think that we should invest in American companies, not French ones. So that would be an example. I believe America First. I think everybody here in this county would concur that we could find an American company to put $2 million with instead of a French one, as an example.
Is there anything that a person in your office can do to encourage economic growth in the county? That was a pretty good question. Unanswerable, perhaps, Terry.
Economic growth, I would say that we have some people that have contacted us as far as TOT seems to be a pretty hot topic, and they contact us in regards to what they can do as far as renting out. And for TOT, it's transient occupancy tax for those that want to, for visitors that come to our county, that basically a lot of people rent out a room or rent out their home for a period of time. That's something that we, actually surprisingly, it's a significant amount for our small county. That's one thing I could think of off the top of my head for economic growth. There's a lot of areas that I believe that we could work on, but with the limited staff that we haven't been able to approach all of that just yet. So do have something to add, yes.
Diane?
Well, I have been a lobbyist for a long time, both at the national and the state level, and many of the things that I do work for are basically for ranchers and farmers to promote that industry, which is what Trinity is, or what used to be logging, mining, and ranching. We do have the cannabis, and that could become a bigger industry here. For instance, I would love to see it as a medical destination. I'm very supportive of the medical component for cannabis, and I think that that would be the niche for Trinity County, and we could definitely see revenue because of that. Of course, that's something for the supervisors, but I think I could crunch the numbers and show why it would be beneficial for the county to do something like that. I also want to, I am working towards and have been working towards the logging to get the logging up and going. I established the number one priority logging program project in Trinity County, Shasta Trinity, which is a shaded fuel break. That was my proposal. Thanks.
Or at any events that might be in your local communities. So with that little filibuster, we're now into your three minutes. We'll keep the same sequence since we just have the two. Terry?
Thank you again for this opportunity. I've absolutely appreciated the privilege of serving as your treasurer tax collector since 2009. It's been an incredible opportunity and a serious obligation to serve the constituents of Trinity County. The duties and responsibility of the treasurer tax collector are established by laws, codes, and county ordinances. As an elected official, I have a fiduciary responsibility. I am compliant and subject to the prudent investor standard. My job in the summarized version, it is to collect, protect, and invest the vital revenues of the county. We've survived some challenging times, and we anticipate that there'll be many more challenging days ahead. I have a wonderful team that works hard and strives to ensure the best experience of community members. I truly appreciate their attitudes, ethics, and service. We survived the turmoil when the state decided to issue the county's IOUs. We endured the housing market crash and withstood the sustained near-zero interest rate environment without any detrimental effects. It's the caring, committed people that make us a superb team. I would like to touch a little bit about some misstatements. So in regards to negative fund balances, again, that is not a treasurer tax function. That is an auditor function. The courthouse is still, the courthouse belongs to the courthouse. It is a pledged asset for a debt financing, and that's also something that's underway for refinancing currently. Red flags are not pertaining to the treasurer tax collector's office. And in addition to, there is a very stringent process in regards to hiring employees, and most definitely in pertaining to handling cash. So that being said, I am committed to fulfilling my legal obligation to collect and protect the vital revenues of local government. I take my responsibilities seriously, and I'm dedicating to making this county great. I have the formal educational knowledge and the expert experience from serving as your current treasurer tax collector, which makes me the best choice for your future treasurer tax collector. I look forward to serving you for another 4 years. Thank you.
Personnel in that office. I'm going to bring in a forensic auditor who was with the State of California Franchise Tax Board, one of the top auditors. They have agreed to move here, and we will know where every dime is every day, and it will be posted so that you know as well. I'm going to also bring in a consultant to help reorganize it so that we have better practices internal. And again, the audit said there's a problem. And obviously it's either between the treasurer and the auditor, but there's an internal problem. So I'm going to bring in a CPA that took over as a consultant only, that took over the largest employer in Oakland, was in bankruptcy, and he made that flush, and he was a CPA, and then he was the CEO, and he will assist as well. So we can find out where this $100 million every year is going. We want to know where every dime is, and we want 100% transparency. So I know where it is, and you know where it is. Often during the Board of Supervisors meetings, when they're budgeting or asking for money, they'll say, well, where's that money? There's no money in that account. Oh, it's somewhere in some account. We've seen this year after year after year. Why are those monies in some other account? That's part of the job of the treasurer to maintain those bank accounts. That's cash. So I intend to get very expert at this. Our office will have very high level people. I may very well retain Terry because she was an employee there for a long time. There's no reason for her not to be there. I don't know why that's funny. She was a good employee all this time. But there are things in our investments, for instance, that have not changed at all since 1992. It's just you put the your on the table and it's just riding. And I think there's things that can be done with that, as well as finding out where is our money. Where is this $100 million a year going? Don't you want to know why don't we have the amount of sheriffs that we used to have, deputies? We used to have a lot more deputies and we had a lot less money. How come that's happening? There must be the money, must be there going somewhere, but not to public safety. So that's what I want, one of the things I want to find out. And that's going to be my job, to figure out where that is and find those monies for the programs that we really need, like public safety. So I hope you'll put your trust in me. I won't let you down. Thank you very much for coming tonight.
Okay, thanks, ladies. We'll play musical chairs again. The next office we'll deal with is clerk, recorder, assessor, and elections. If you're more comfortable down there at the end, you can just stay there or make a joint decision there.
Yeah. We do have microphones over in the center that we don't have all the way to the end.
You're right, so let's move.
All right.
And ladies and gentlemen, it remains to be seen whether or not we're going to take a break, but it's likely that we'll take one in about 10 minutes. Okay, we have Brenda Peeney, Shauna White, and Lisa Wright going left to right there, ladies and gentlemen. And since I read off the names that way, we'll start in that fashion as well. This is 3 minutes, introductory statement. Brenda?
As you all know, I'm Corinne Zampini, and I have spent the last 12 years fighting for our rights and freedoms. Our right to liberty and the pursuit of happiness is constantly being threatened by officials who believe that the people are not capable of governing their own lives. This needs to change, and it needs to start at our elections. Making sure that our elections are honest is the first step to ensuring our liberty. The second step is to involve the public in every aspect of the electoral process. From voting, to observing elections, to running for office, the people must participate, and as our elections officer, it will be my mission to make sure all these activities are easy to do and that more people participate in running our county and our country. Our assessments are too high and are in fact abnormal, with a backlog of appeals caused by misassessments. Our poor citizens are suffering because of this incorrect application of tax laws, and are unable to find relief from the current assessor's office. Please join me in getting Trinity County back its prosperity by voting for me so that we can live our lives knowing that there are people who will fight for us and that we can fight for ourselves. Thank you so much for having me tonight, and I look forward to your questions.
Shauna?
Hi, I'm Shauna White. I'm your current clerk, recorder, assessor. I'd like to thank Serafinus and Judge Letton and all of you for coming out tonight out of your busy lives to meet your candidates before casting your vote. A little bit about me. I moved to Trinity County in 1982. I married my husband Greg 30 years ago, and we're successful business owners of White Construction and Roofing. We're the proud parents of two daughters who were born and raised in Trinity County. So my career began in Trinity County 23 years ago as an account clerk in the Auditor Controller's Office. Through hard work and dedication, I am now your County Clerk, Recorder, Assessor. I currently hold my certified tax appraiser certificate, and I'm 3 courses away from my advanced certificate. I also hold a certificate in Recordable Document Examiner and have completed courses towards a California Professional Elections Administration credential. I continue to attend annual trainings to keep me up on various law changes and procedures. Since my appointment, I've done everything possible to protect the confidentiality of voters' information and have run elections honestly and fairly and followed all election codes. I've increased office hours open to the public. I've implemented the ability to examine official records electronically. With the assistance of the Treasurer Tax Collector, we can also now collect fees via credit card. I've dedicated the past 23 years to Trinity County, and most importantly, the last 8 in this office. My experience has provided me the knowledge and understanding that ensures these departments run efficiently and with integrity. Although I may not be the best public speaker, I am the candidate with the most experience for this position, and I look forward to continue serving you and would appreciate your vote on June 5th. Thank you.
Lisa Wright.
Good evening, I'm Lisa Wright. Thank you to the Soroptimist, Judge Levin, for putting this event on. I'm here tonight to ask you to make the right choice this election. You've had nearly a decade of Board of Supervisor appointed clerk assessor reporters, I'm going to refer to as the CRA, except for a few months of elected officials. And I think that that may have contributed to some of the issues we're having now. Let's look at some of the facts. In 2016, the grand jury issued a report citing several violations of election code by the current appointed CRA. That's very concerning. I served on the grand jury in 2010, and they based their reports on facts. They're not rumors or vendettas like some people may have you believe. They take their job very seriously and spend nearly a year putting those facts together before they present them to the judge. Second, there was a 2015 Board of Equalization report during the office tenure of the now appointed CRA that found 22 areas of significant problems in the assessment practices. I've been unable to find any public reports on how these corrections are being made with these fact-based findings. All I hear are denials. So you might say, who's Lisa Wright? You haven't heard of me, you haven't seen me around. So let's take you back to the third grade with me to the library day when I was searching out every biography that I could find on the American presidency. By the sixth grade, I thought I was going to be the next president. In high school, I was walking door-to-door on cold Midwestern election days, trying to get people out to vote. So I've been enthralled with democracy since I was a child. I went on to earn a bachelor's degree in political science and French, a master's degree in public administration, and I was selected as one of 200 to the presidential management program during the Reagan and into the Bush administrations, really with the goal of improving the efficiency and effectiveness of government. I served in the Department of Justice at the Executive Office for U.S. Trustees, where we rolled out a self-funded pilot program nationwide with investment authority. I also received training at that time in fraud.